thank you all for coming today to the official launch and ribbon cutting of the History Check app and future website. I'd like to acknowledge that while today's event takes place on Treaty 6 territory, the History Check app also includes sites in Treaty 8 territory, both of which are traditional lands of the First Nation Métis people. So I'm Sheila Willis, Executive Director of Historical Northern Alberta Society, and everybody can call us FNAS because it's a lot easier to say. So, our light bulb moment happened on January 12, 2015, when a group of people interested in heritage tourism in Northern Alberta met and discussed ways to share the localized site stories, as well as activities, buildings, and artifacts of our history. The goal was not to replace existing websites, but to guide them, people to them, so that interested people would not need to spend hours of time and looking at hundreds of websites to find out how to access information or visit these places in Northern Alberta. In areas where resources of time, volunteers, or finances were scarce, local historians and organizations could use History Check to add information about their region, and we invite them all to do so. And of course, we'll try to fill in the blanks where we can. So our board members include people from across the Northern Alberta region. Each brings something special to the table with backgrounds ranging from archaeology to motorcycle tourism. So I'd like to thank the past and present board members for your leadership in this project. In addition, I'd also like to recognize Scott Astle, our tech lead, Linda Collier, one of the original Lightbulb people, and Bacon Seed technology team that built the app. Scott has more than 1,000 hours of volunteer time on this project. He was terrific at taking my concepts and putting them into techie terms that the Bacon Seed team could understand. Linda's done everything from being a sounding board for me, and she's also entered in all of the data for Edmonton, so she's been an invaluable source. So Scott, Linda, and the team from Bacon Seed, thank you for moving this forward. So we've scheduled our launch to coincide with Archives Week. One of the items within the Provincial Archives collection is a diary by Hugh McIntyre, who was the front man for the Edmonton, Dunvegan, and British Columbia Railway, coming through in 1912. His diary offers a great descriptive account of his journey from Edmonton to Spirit River, but one passage struck me as the importance of archival donations. So I'm going to read this because I love this phrase. Dear me, here I'm at it again. This diary is all right, maybe, but about this time it seems to be a confounded nuisance. When I think of the gibberish I've written, it makes me tired as I haven't read it over for some time. It, no doubt, is much worse than I imagine. However, it does not matter much, for the chances are no one else will handle these leaves but myself. Well, Hugh, wherever you are, you're wrong. Some of your story is going into the History Check app. So, I think we all know that the archives are essential to the preservation of our history, and without them we would not find gems like Hugh's diary. So on that note, I would like to thank Rini Georgopoulos, Executive Director of the Archives Society, to come say a few words.
Thanks, Sheila. Archives Week is celebrated in our province every year during the first week of October. And this year's theme is Alberta and the Great War, and we're commemorating the end of World War I. So the purpose of the week is to just share with the public why archives are important and why the work archivists do is important. And I often like to stress to people who don't know much about archives that archives have many uses that you might not be aware of. So they inspire artistic works. So that can be anything from books to paintings. They can be facts in a documentary, a museum exhibit, or books. And they can even be evidence in court cases. So today we are seeing the launch of the History Check app, and this is just another use of archival information, which is great. So I look forward to seeing the app today. And I also look forward to seeing more archival information added to the app in the future. And I think it's a great way to highlight archives in the province. And lastly, I just encourage you all to go check out the events for Archives Week this week. Thank you so much.
files already that are using provincial archives photographs, and we thank them for that. So people love historical photographs. Oops. So imagine you're all thinking, okay, it's an app, what's all the fuss about? So I'm going to walk you through it. I think that its potential for heritage preservation and promotion, its use as an educational tool, and the potential for economic development across the Northern Alberta region are huge. So as you can see, we've literally put Northern Alberta on the map. We have 330 plus communities, and by using the Zoom, you can go see an individual area, or you can see all of it. So touching any of these are going to take you to the category menu. The primary goal of History Check is to encourage heritage tourism, but Northern Alberta is also a remote region. So by selecting options, the visitors can find local attractions and services while they explore, engage, and experience all that Northern Alberta has to offer, whether from their living room or on the ground. Right now we're an app, eventually we'll be a website as well. So this is Smith. We currently have about 1,000 of these points of interest added, and as more regions and businesses submit their information, we expect to have well over 10,000. So funding for the app will come through business advertising, using interest-driven search functions and branding. There is actually no cost to put any point of interest on the app, and so for not-for-profits and other heritage organizations, anything that you add is free. So notice the little green dude at the bottom left. That's me at my house taking a screenshot. So there's actually location services on this as well. So they can find themselves, people can find themselves zooming in or out, or using the near me button on the bottom left, which will show everything that's around you. And again, the zoom feature will take you between the primary and the point of interest icons, as we call them. Each one of those opens up into a point of interest screen, such as this one. So whether for history or any other category, they're following the same format. If you touch the photograph, you get a gallery of up to three. So touching any of these will put them in the main view. If you'll notice the See More option, right there, it actually takes you into the storyline. So you might notice also that people can call the number, visit a website, or even send an email through this screen without leaving the app. There are several points of interest where we've actually added YouTube videos, and some of the Métis settlements is actually what I just put those on. I found some really great videos. So if there's an online link to the story, we can give a brief synopsis and we don't have to rewrite the story. Wat Mae, Mercy Flight is actually a really good example of that. Then we have the For More Information page, which supplies people with additional references. And as Rennie was saying, this will be where a lot of archival things, online links are shared, but we can also, we're going to create a page where if we're referencing such as Hugh McIntyre's, where it's just a file that's not online, we can tell people where to get that information. So the logo on the left is actually a website link, so it'll take you out. And on other historical points of interest, this is where we can do some sponsorship. So the blue slide out arrow is actually a menu that allows for social media sharing. So it will bring more attention not only to the app, but our history. And I think that's a good thing. People can also take selfies and add comments, so it becomes an interactive map. This is my favorite part. For each point of interest, we add keywords that people can search. It could be Wat Mae, HBC, previous place names, railway, fur trade, or any other identifier. So when you're searching this, you're going to get a list, which is fine and dandy, but in an instant by pushing the map button, you immediately see them in their geographical location. So I can track the EDBC Railroad all the way through Northern Alberta, or places where David Thompson has been referenced. So as we add more and more of that information, I know for me, place names, you're reading a book, you're thinking, where in the world is that? Search history, check and see. So I think that's just, for history, that's amazing. But you can also search golf or pizza. So I'm a person that likes hard copy information, so we've added the visitor information centers. You can see the green person in the middle, that would have been me taking a screenshot. By accessing the yellow button on the bottom, you can immediately see where the visitor information centers are around you and zoom in and out and find them. So I think that's pretty cool. We broke the primary icons down into categories. You'll recognize that some of the icons have gold stars on them. Those are the municipalities that contributed to this project. Edmonton is included as a gold star region through the contributions of the Edmonton and District Historical Society. We've also included First Nations and Métis settlements. So we're currently putting them on the map and linking to their history pages and are encouraging them to give us more information. So to truly represent Alberta's history, one must include the history of the Indigenous people. So at this time, I'd like to invite Chief Calvin Bruno, Bobbis Chase, First Nation tour.
Morning, everybody. I'd like to thank Sheila again for the invitation to be here. I just want to welcome everybody to Bobbis Chase Cree Nation territory, Rachiondia Reserve. And when we signed treaty back in 1877, my ancestor Bobbis Chase did, they chose reserve as part of the terms and conditions of the treaty. And that was on the south side here. And it was supposed to be actually more towards Waida Ave University area at the edge of the river lots that they had developed back then. But the settlers and early politicians didn't want them close by, so they moved them down here. So that's why the north boundary is 51st Avenue. So we're just within the boundaries of the reserve. So that's why I say welcome to Bobbis Chase Cree Nation territory and also Treaty 6 territory. We still, I'm not going to get to all the history and all that, but we say this is still unceded treaty lands. And it was taken away legally, so that's why I say that. But Sheila approached me a while back, you know, a number of months ago, about this app and what she was doing, and this project. And it really interested me, because I'm also a student of history myself. I had to learn our history. And I've been here in the archives as well, doing research, but also a number of resources. University and libraries and whatnot, but also other researchers, historians, elders. And this, to me, is a great resource for people who not only have an interest in history, but also for schools and people even coming to this country, even people coming from other provinces. This is great to help initiate, you might say, the people in our province and show what we have to offer. You know, looking at our history. And so to me, this is also a good way of reconciliation. You know, you've heard that term before many times. And I think working together and collaborating is, to me, is reconciliation. And by acknowledging that, that's why I'm very glad that Sheila has acknowledged the First Nations history, because without it, without the fur trade, without early settlement and all that, we wouldn't have Western Canada. But also we wouldn't have Canada as it is, the First Nations involvement, the War of 1812, Louis Riel, not giving in to Americans for a couple examples, but also helping the early fur traders and the early explorers, you know, learning how to survive and being guides up here and interpreters. And so, so to me, it's always been a collaborating process. And for a time, it's basically we've been left out of the mix. And that's why now it's very important that you know, working together. And so I'm glad to be part of this. And you know, I really hope for the success of this app and the website and that. And you know, people who learn from it, they get the sense of the history, you know, the province, also tourism as well. You know, I hope that people, you know, around the world can actually look in on us and, you know, start looking at you know, our province and, you know, want to come here. So just thank you for that, and just hope Sheila, the board, and everybody's success, and you know, I'm just supporting this all the way. Thank you.
So, from the light bulb moment, when we had our first first meeting on January 12, 2015. Should be me. A hotelier from Canisowet as our tech lead and a retired school teacher, Linda, doing all she could. We did pretty darn good. However, we didn't do it alone. We have this scroll sitting out here. We call it our appreciation scroll. It's a partial list of those who have given what they could, whether it be sharing on social media, creating awareness, adding content, or contributing financially. So this is over 35 feet long now, and if anybody would like to come and sign it today, feel free. We will be donating it to the Provincial Archives as our first donation for FNAS. So one of the downfalls of being a group that takes a ball and runs with it is you don't give a lot of people notice to schedule to be here. So during our soft launch on September 24th, the Honorable Daniel Larrabee, MLA of Lesser Slave Lake, as well as the Minister of Children's Services, came and spoke, as well as my reeve, Marie Carrick, from the MD of Lesser Slave River. We also had a lot of other people, such as Calvin, came to that one, Shirley Lowe. Having said that, we don't have any elected officials in-house today, but Arnold Pearson, MP for Peace River Westlock, has sent his regards via this video clip, and I hope it works.
Hey everyone, Arnold Pearson here, Member of Parliament for Peace River Westlock. I'm glad you're all here today for the ribbon cutting and the launch of the History Check app. Sheila Willis has kept me up to speed over the last couple of years as to the progression and the building of this app. I'm looking forward to using it, and I'm looking forward to having the resource at my fingertips to share with others across Northern Alberta. I hope that it's a great inspiration to bring tourism to our area, and I know that we're all going to be excited to use it. So thank you for being here today. Let's go use the History Check app.
I'm trying to find a letter that I forgot to put a picture of. So. Linda, do you have an email I sent you yesterday? Okay. So Ron Orr, the MLA for Lekwungenoka, wrote me a letter, which I cannot find now. And I'll put it online later. So I met him several years ago at a tourism conference in Camrose, and he picked up the concept for the History Check right off the bat. So we've stayed in touch with his progress, and as I said, I'll put the letter online later, but he basically congratulated us due to the need for more tourism in Northern Alberta. So I'd also like to thank the Alberta Historical Resources Foundation, also known as ARF. It wasn't long after that light bulb meeting that I scheduled an appointment with the executive director, Matthew Wengler. He more than likely thought I was a nut job with big dreams and lofty goals, but he didn't get them any better. So since then, we've had some great conversations, and I'd like to thank ARF for their contribution through the Heritage Preservation Partnership Program. It's like us, we named ourselves Friends of Historical Northern Alberta Society. Could we have made it smaller? Anyways, I would like to invite Everett Bort, a board member of ARF, to come to the city.
Yes, good morning. As Sheila indicated, my name is Everett Bort. I'm one of the newer board members of the Alberta Historical Resource Foundation. If anybody's not familiar with the provincial board that supports archaeology, historical, genealogical societies, most of the museums and the archives in the province. Our mission of the Albert Historic Resource Foundation is to encourage initiatives that preserve and interpret Albert's rich heritage. I was very interested and pleased to have the opportunity to come here this morning because as one of the agenda items in our last board meeting was the discussion regarding the signage and markers that you see throughout the province when you drive down the highways. The ongoing production, installation, and maintenance of these signs led to a discussion about other means of sharing historical and heritage information with the public. Eventually, the discussion led to the potential use of technology in helping to achieve this goal. I'm certain that the launch of the historical check app is one technological approach that will facilitate the continued sharing of Alberta's history, in that it should be a cost-effective and very appropriate means of obtaining historical information for a generation whose primary means of communication is based on technology. Our young people, they use primarily cell phones, iPads, and all those other applications. I'm hoping that they will engage this wholeheartedly. I'll be very brief this morning. I have to say congratulations. Prior to my role on this board, I actually spent 40 years with TELUS. So I have a technical background. It's very impressive that you can get an app up in less than 1,000 days. So Sheila, Linda, Scott, that is a tremendous accomplishment to achieve that. I actually worked in the service development area, so I know what goes into managing a project, the technology behind it, the coding, and all the rest of the work that goes into this. So congratulations. That's quite amazing. So I'm very pleased to see innovation and an innovative approach that will help to preserve and interpret Alberta's rich heritage. So thank you and congratulations again.
So I'm not sure if I mentioned these people already, but there's a team out of Toronto. It's an international company, and their name is Vacancy Technology. I have spent many a late-night Skype meeting with them, I can tell you. So they're the people that actually built the app, and we really twisted their minds a couple of times. But Benel, Sumit, Mohit, Parinda, thank you very much. You did a wonderful job. So I think it is time to cut the ribbon. So Everett? Can we all share the scissors and do this? You'll notice that I do not have a standard ribbon because I don't do anything according to plan. These are all the colors of the categories on history check. So.
Sheila, do you have a screen related to ribbon coding that you want behind your pictures?
There you go.
All right,
there we go. Totally forgot about the screen. Who wants to manhandle these beads?
Ooh. Oh, wow.
Do it big if you're going to do it at all. All right.
Wheat fields here we come.
You
want
to do the master honors?
Oh, here, let's see if we can all do this. Can you get your hands on there?
Everybody?
Yeah, everybody. And squeeze away. Okay. This is probably
woo! We're done.